finally got all the appropriate forms done, and we got them on an airplane. They left. They had fled a little town called Bulgari on the east side of Kiev, and they fled that town on the very first day. The bombs actually woke them up, and they decided to go out here, and very wisely they left. They then fled to Poland, and for those of you who would like to read an exciting account of that, I'll tell you where to find it. It's an amazing story that Svetlana was sort of the force behind all this, and they finally made it to Poland and stayed there for about 7 or 8 months, and we were communicating at that point. And then they left Poland, they went through Copenhagen and direct to Dulles, and we picked them up at Dulles on December the 6th of last year. So I'd like to introduce them, the father of Polo and mother of the the oldest, Timor, and the middle young son, Timor.
We are honored to have you with us, and welcome. We're happy you're able to.
I said you came. You were happy here in Lexington. So I'm going to get on with the program now. We will. This is Oxford's. This is a free concert, so it's Oxford's gift to you guys. But if you care to make donations, and it's not necessary, but if you do, a portion of them will go to the Ukrainian Recovery Fund. And so now I want to introduce you to our new pastor, Rob Sherrard, and then we'll be starting the concert.
Good evening, and you folks don't realize that this morning's message was on temptation, and anytime a preacher sees a crowd this large, it is a terribly big temptation. Since we had scheduled this concert, though, the hymn, This Is My Father's World, has been going around in my mind. This is my Father's world, and to my listening ears, all nature sings and round me rings the music of the spheres. Wow. That's what we're going to hear tonight. The music of the spheres that God blends into our lives and enriches us so much. And we are delighted to have the musicians here with us this evening. And I thought it would be appropriate if we could just begin with a word of prayer. Lord Jesus, we thank you for calling us together for this reason and in this place. We appreciate those who have preserved Oxford Presbyterian Church over the years and how they have fit in with your plans for this area. We thank you for all these folks who have graciously given their time and come here this evening. Lord, enrich them with your grace of music. Bless the musicians as they play. And help us all to enjoy each other's company. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Okay, Kevin, we're ready for you. And take over.
So I'm taking over. So we will start our concert with Greig. Edvard Grieg is a Norwegian composer of romantical period. He was born in 1843. And the first piece we're going to play is an aria from his Holberg Suite. It's a melody written in D minor, cello, part of the suite which is written in Baroque style. However, it varies harmonies, rhythm, and emotional drama of romantical music. And I think in today's world, when Russian and Ukrainians fighting, this is a piece which reflects the tragedy of what's going on. So I'm on the piano, I'm on the Billias, and I'll be on the cello.
Thank you.
was told to come to microphone every time I speak. So
I'm sorry I wasn't down here.
The next piece is a Solveig song. This composition is a part of Peer Gynt's suite, which was written for drama of Henrik Ibsen. Peer Gynt is a character of Norwegian myths, and the play follows his adventures from young age to death. And he was not that likable person. He was lazy, he cheated, he stole stuff, and he was looking always for easier life. So on the way he left a lot of people behind, and Solveig was one of them. It was his beloved at some point, but then he left, and at the end of his life, the devil comes to him and tells him, you know, your life was not great, so you go on with me. And Peer Gynt is always looking for ways out, ask, is any way we can fix that? And the devil said, all right, if you can find one person who still likes you, I'll let you go. Peer Gynt was looking far and wide, and guess what? He found Solveig, who still loved him, who had still warm feelings for him, and the moral of the story is that love is the best thing we have in life, redeeming force. So we're going to play her song, Solveig song.
Thank you.
see what you mean about temptation. Feels good. The next two songs, arrangement from piano pieces. Grieg was famous for composing short piano pieces. The one I will start with called To Spring. I think that's on the mind of all of us. We really want it to come sooner. And the second one is Nocturne. Spring, you can hear, I don't know, Russian waters, thunderstorms, also beautiful flowers. And in Nocturne, as you know, it is a night song, Nocturne. You will hear probably the sounds of the night, as well as maybe passion and love. Enjoy. Thank you.
So in 1886, Edvard Grieg was 43 years old, and he met a 19-year-old violinist and was completely enthralled by her playing. He wrote a letter to his music publisher and said, quote, "If ever I write anything for the violin again, she will be to blame." Well, sure enough, he started work on this violin sonata. It was his third sonata. The previous two he wrote fairly quickly, but this one he worked on for over a year. And when he felt like he had it pretty much done, he went on a trip to Leipzig to show it to his publisher, but also to go to the Leipzig Conservatory, and he wanted the input of Johann Halvorsen, who was a violin professor at the Leipzig Conservatory. Halvorsen said, hey, you should show it to my other colleague, Adolf Brodsky, who also worked over another violinist. And Adolf Brodsky actually gave the premiere performance. Grieg played the piano and Brodsky on violin. And they made a few little revisions, mostly changing the dynamics, making things more contrast. The piece became, once it was published, it became an international success. It was being performed all over. An author of the day mentioned Grieg's third sonata in his novel. And Grieg actually played this sonata for the rest of his life, performing it many places. This sonata has become a standard of the violin repertoire, considered up there with Brahms' violin sonatas and also César Franck's sonata. It's dramatic, it's bold, it's exuberant, but it's also filled with a lot of passion, and there are these beautiful, soft, transcendental moments. So I hope you will enjoy this sonata as much as Anna and I have enjoyed rehearsing it.
Thank you. Thank you.
After that, that's why we take intermission, because I can break it.
How long did it take?
10 minutes is fine.
10 minutes, folks, and then we'll come back to the second half of the space.